saying that doesn't really work here either. It's the wrong weapon for this particular battlefield. The Ranger Adrian's going to tell you about the right weapon.
All right, so by default, if that's the brown best musket, then this is. I don't know, it's not an answer. Rifle. All right, this is a rifle, not a military weapon. All right, but a weapon used for
hunting.
Correct, hunting. All right. So, as you can tell, this gun is nice. All right, some of y'all ladies might say it's pretty cute. Some of the guys might say it's cool. All right. This is it's a nice gun. It cost me a 1 whole year's salary, all right? So if I wasn't a gunsmith, if I didn't make my own weapon, I would have to purchase it, all right? Who gave her weapon?
Britain. All right,
before I ask another question, if I ask y'all a question, I want a serious answer, all right? Let's put all jokes aside, all jokey answers. Let's put on our thinking caps, all right? We can have fun after this, but this is an education program, so we want to be serious and learn something, all right? So if I ask you a question, ask it as serious as possible. All right, I heard some goofy answers. I want y'all to take something from it, all right? So this weapon was not smooth, as you can tell, all right? It was more accurate, all right? But it took me 1 full minute to load one shot, all right? How many shots a minute would she get?
Three.
All right, so I'm getting one shot per minute, all right? So what I would have to do, I'm actually loading from a powder horn. All right, everything you see me have, I would have brought. All right, because I'm basically a volunteer. I'm not a soldier, I'm a volunteer. So I had to bring pretty much everything. So I have to measure out my powder. Pour some in there, put some in my pan. All right, both of these weapons are flintlock weapons, which means your life depends on a rock, all right? Does anybody want to take a guess what I mean by that? What do I mean by your life depends on a rock? Correct. All right, so without a spark, these weapons will not work. All right, so that's what I mean by your life depends on a rock. Can y'all imagine that? Mm-hmm. You can see again? Well, I can't imagine. All right, so I'll have to get my bullet out. All right, this is a 50 caliber rifle. All right, fired a 49.5 caliber rifle ball. All right, could I easily just drop that to the bottom? Nah, I couldn't easily drop that because it's only 0.5 smaller than the barrel. All right, and one else thing I would have to do is pretty much cut a piece of cloth patch off to give it that tight fit. All right, why would I want to have a tight fit? So it's more accurate, correct. So like you said, you can equate that to a pitcher's knuckleball. When the rifle is fired, you can equate that to a quarterback spiral. All right, got any football fans out here? No, I got some football fans. All right. So this weapon was 250 yards to 300 yards. So how many football fields is 300 yards?
Three.
How many is she? Almost half, right? All right. So which gun would you rather have? All right. Let's see if your mind stays that way as we continue. All right. So the only way to really defend myself from a bayonet charge was. My tomahawk, bill, axe, hatchet, whatever you want to call it. All right, so on the reach test, who's going to win?
Her?
Yes. It was no way that I could defend myself from a bayonet charge fighting hand-to-hand combat, all right? So what would be the best thing for me to do?
Run.
The correct answer would be to run, but we're going to address the answer that you gave. You said throw it. All right, say for instance, if you were my target and I hit you, am I going back to get my axe?
No.
All right, if I miss you, am I going back to get it?
No.
All right, you know, maybe if you threw it back, I can one hand, maybe like Odell. That'd probably be the only way that I would get it back, all right? But I said all that to say this. You wanted to use the tree, all right? Are y'all familiar with cow pens?
Mm-hmm.
See how flat that is?
Yeah.
All right, here we have a lot of hills, a lot of trees, all right? So what I would do as a patriot, I would find a tree, all right? I pretty much adopted these war tactics from fighting the Native Americans. So what they did, we call them guerrilla warfare. Does that resonate? Yeah, so we call them guerrilla warfare today. So it's basically finding a tree, loading, take me a shot, find me another tree, load again, all right? So you want to live to fight another day, all right? Major Patrick Ferguson, her commander, sent out a nasty threat saying he was going to pretty much kill my family, burn down my house, probably a house I built from my hand. So you mean to tell me you're going to do what? Nah, I don't believe words. You might have to show me something. All right, so I didn't wait for action. I took action immediately, all right? Because remember, I defended my family, but I also want to get back to them, right? So yeah, it's better to use your feet, your mind, and these trees, all right? So this is one of the few battles, Revolutionary War battles, actually won by rifle, all right? Anybody want to take a guess how long the battle lasted?
2 hours.
Y'all getting close? All right, think about how long is your favorite two shows?
30 minutes.
About
an hour.
Alright, we're going to do some firing for y'all. But first, we want to show you the drill that Ferguson's loyalist militia had to learn. These guys, Ferguson was training to be proper British soldiers. So they had to learn a 12-step loading and firing drill, which they would do in camp, so that in battle they could do those steps without thinking. So we'll go through that real quick and then we'll load together. Ranger Adrian, you'll be my commander, sir.
Alright. Soldiers up here. Shoulder arms. Recover arms. Handle cartridge. Prime. And I see why you need your teeth. Shut pan. Charge with cartridge. Draw rammer. Ram down cartridge. Return rammer. Shoulder fire lock. To the right about face. Poise fire lock. Cock fire lock. Take aim. See what we fire.
That was pretty quiet.
I know.
Riley, did you hear what he just said? He said, that was quiet.
Commander's going to sit there and tell me all that.
No.
In battle, you get one command, prime, and load. So this time, Ranger Adrian and I are going to be loading at the same time. So y'all can notice the differences in how we load and in how long it takes.
Mr. Mayfield.